I'm Tracy Baxter with today's Record News Watch. Saying the failed implementation of the Common Core standards and the state testing program have made the state a, quote, national embarrassment, Middletown School District Superintendent Dr. Kenneth Eastwood made a public plea to the governor and state legislature today to immediately end the rollout of the Common Core program until appropriate in-service resources and practice opportunities are provided to schools and staff to teach the new standards, and that it should happen before any assessments are made.
We, before you, parents, teachers, administrators, and members of the Middletown School District Board of Education, are begging Governor Cuomo and the New York State Legislature to end the educational madness in New York State through immediate legislative action to reset what started as a good thing for our students and is now at a point of confusion, failure, and harassment.
In his statement today calling for a new state education direction, Eastwood said, quote, year after year our children deal with state exams that are flawed and we continue to pay millions of dollars for more of the same, while the state education department makes excuses for why the trend of incompetence continues, end quote. In other news today, it will be a way for local veterans to help their comrades. Today, the Mental Health Association of Orange County provided details of its new vet-to-vet support program for military veterans. Orange County Mental Health was awarded a state grant of $185,000 to get the program off the ground. Peer networking meetings are held in three Orange County locations now, giving veterans a chance to talk with other vets about issues like post-traumatic stress, addiction, employment problems, and thoughts of suicide. A vitally important topic for discussion since at least 22 of our veterans are taking their own lives every day.
The design of the program is to really provide the veterans and the members of the armed services the resources to destigmatize mental health. Because I myself, when I was dealing with challenges, I was in denial of the issues I had. And it wasn't for a veteran who guided me and said, hey, you know what, this is what I did. Maybe you want to give it a shot. And almost 10 years later, I'm here in front of you as a prime example of how peer-to-peer works. Vet-to-Vet provides the members of the armed services and veterans the opportunity to network with one another in a safe and non-judgmental environment. We have no restrictions. So individuals, regardless of their discharge status, their dates of service, they are welcome.
Vet-to-Vet meetings are held each Monday at 6 p.m. at Thraw Library in Middletown, Tuesdays at 2:30 at Hudson House on Broadway in Newburgh, and on Wednesdays at 12:30 at the Port Jervis Public Library. Plenty of casino-related activity in the region yesterday. In Orange County, the Montgomery Town Board gave its approval for Genting Americas to apply for a gaming license for a $500 million casino resort that would be built off Route 17K and Interstate 84. As that was happening, the Woodbury Village Board was voting unanimously to support a proposed Caesars Entertainment Casino on vacant land off Route 17 near the Harriman Metro North train station. That project would still need the expected endorsement of the Woodbury Town Board. And in Ulster County Thursday, final design plans were unveiled for a $640 million resort casino at the site of the former Neville Hotel in Wawarsing. Neville Investors CEO Michael Trainer says he believes his project meets the casino location criteria set by the state.
We have support that is unrivaled. No project in the state of New York will be able to boast the type of support that we have. So, you know, we've worked with the SUNY system. We've worked with the regional chambers. We've worked with the, you know, Hudson Valley Economic Development Corporation. With so many different stakeholders on this, it's hard to imagine that this model right here is not going to become reality a half a mile in that direction.
Applications for state gaming licenses must be filed by June 30th, and developers must get resolutions of support from local governments. The Phys Ed building at the SUNY Orange Middletown campus now has a new name. Last evening, it was officially dedicated the Edward A. Diana Physical Education Center. In honor of Ed Diana, longtime Orange County executive and member of the Orange County Community College class of 1968. Family, friends, and government colleagues were on hand for an event that Diana called a truly humbling experience.
This is probably the best honor I've ever received in my lifetime. I was just so humbled to hear they're going to name a building after it, Diana. I mean, it's just incredible. My name will live on forever. The Diana family legacy will live on. You know, my Aunt Mary and I had an Aunt Jane that taught here for many years. Both of them are very instrumental in this college being as successful as it is today. Certainly, I went to school here. I went further my education after this. Gave me my start in life. Certainly, I was on a student senate here, so it started my political career, I guess. This means an awful lot to me.
Diana's political career began back in the 1980s in the town of Wallkill government, and he taught phys ed in the Menasing Valley School District for 31 years. Besides the renaming, a SUNY Orange County scholarship has also been created in his name. A Newburgh man has been sentenced to 2 years and 90 days in jail for the attempted rape of a New Paltz College student. 21-year-old Maximilian Hunte was convicted at trial of attempted rape, attempted sexual misconduct, and related charges for a September 2012 incident at a residence following a college party. Authorities say Hunte had attempted to rape the highly intoxicated woman when a victim's friend intervened. A Kingston man has been indicted on charges connected to alleged sexual assaults involving children. 59-year-old Kaj Eric Erickson, a.k.a. Richard Lewis, was named in a multi-count indictment containing charges that include predatory sexual assault of a child and criminal sexual act. According to the Ulster County District Attorney's Office, the attacks occurred over 4 years, one child under age 13 and another child under age 15 involved. If he's convicted, Erickson could face between 10 to 25 years in state prison with a maximum of life behind bars. And a Lake Katrine woman is facing an assortment of criminal charges after police in Kingston spotted her driving a pickup truck with a landscaping trailer in tow. The pickup had a flat tire and the trailer had two flat tires. When police attempted to pull the pickup over, 24-year-old Samantha O'Brien jumped out and ran off. Once she was taken into custody, police charged her with DWI, DWI drugs, criminal possession of drugs, resisting arrest, reckless driving, and aggravated unlicensed operation of a motor vehicle. Town of Ulster PD tacked on a leaving the scene of an accident charge. Kingston police say she had taken the truck and trailer without permission and was involved in an earlier hit-and-run property damage accident in the town of Ulster, resulting in those flat tires. We put up with plenty of clouds and rain this week, but we will get rewarded with some very nice weather this weekend. Saturday will be mostly sunny with temperatures getting up around 80 degrees. More of the same on Sunday, more sunshine with the highs at or near 85 degrees. Have a great weekend. But be sure to stay on top of what's happening by reading the Times Herald Record throughout the weekend and keep clicking here at Record Online during the weekend to stay connected to breaking news. For Record News Watch, I'm Tracy Baxter. We'll be right back.